Hello students, in this video we are going to discuss about VI characteristics, voltage versus current characteristics in PN junction diode. It is expected that you are familiar with P-type semiconductor, N-type semiconductor. As you know, in a P-type semiconductor, carriers are hole. In N-type semiconductor, carriers are electrons. So, see here. Suppose this is a P-type semiconductor. As there are holes here, holes positive charge, okay? That is why I have written plus here. So, for convenience, I am drawing relatively larger picture. See here, this is P-type semiconductor. And suppose we have another semiconductor, that is N-type. N-type carriers are negative charge, that is electrons. Here minus represents electrons, here plus represents holes. When they brought in contact, suppose they brought in contact, then what happens? Actually, when a P-type semiconductor is brought into contact with N-type properly, the resulting combination is called a PN junction. This is called PN junction, and diode you may use because it has two electrodes. So it is called PN junction diode. As the junction is formed here, these holes move from P to N side. These electrons move from N to P side. Okay? So plus charges proceed towards the junction. Minus charges from this side proceed towards junction. So when plus and minus combine, they cancel each other. So suppose these negative charges go to the junction. So here positive ions are left. And suppose these plus charges move from P to N side and they combine with these electrons, then negative side, negative charges are left here, negative ions. So once a layer of negative charges this side, once a layer of negative side this side means P side, and positive ions on negative side, N side, then a barrier is set up. Barrier here means they do not allow to further movement of holes and electrons. There is a difference of potential between the two layers, so it is called potential barrier. Now to remove the barrier, so if you want to know what is the value of barrier voltage, then you can see. For a silicon PN junction, it is about 0.7 volt, and for germanium, it is about 0.2 volt. So whenever you want to conduct or you want to maintain the conduction process, you have to remove the barrier. For this, we connect, suppose P-type is connected with the plus terminal, positive terminal of the battery, and N-type is connected with the negative terminal. This type of connection is called forward biasing. Forward biasing. Okay. Biasing means support of battery, connection of battery. So this is called forward biasing. So under forward biasing, we have to see if we change the voltage, corresponding current will be noted here. So only one purpose we have is we have to change the voltage and corresponding currents are noted. So that is called VI characteristics. V voltage, I current, PN junction diode. Okay. Now it is called forward characteristics. Under forward characteristics, if we want to learn what is voltage, what is corresponding current, first we prepare a circuit. You can see here, this is a PN junction diode. Actually, symbol of PN junction diode is this one. This perpendicular line is line stands for negative and this triangular form stands for positive p-type. So it is a PN junction diode, milliammeter, voltmeter, voltage measures voltage, and this is a variable resistance, current, forward current, and we have to change this voltage. Okay. We have to change the voltage through this rheostat and current will be noted here. First, we see that if we come to the graph, we see that there is no current here up to this voltage. Why? As I told you earlier, that there is a barrier. This one is the barrier. So, unless you remove the barrier, you can't imagine to conduction of electrons or holes, that is current. So we have to apply first, we have to remove barrier. So the if the applied voltage is equal to the barrier voltage, then barrier will be removed. And just we increase the voltage, now you will get current. So here, see here, up to this voltage, that is barrier potential. Now if you increase the voltage, if you further increase the voltage, the current increases sharply. See here, this is the voltage versus current graph for germanium and this is for silicon. This is the forward characteristics. Forward characteristics means variation of voltage with current or variation of current with voltage in forward biasing situation. Now we will discuss. See here, one thing I have to mention here, this graph is not a straight line. It is not like this. It is V, it is I. This graph is not a straight line. It means it does not obey Ohm's law because V by R is not constant. Now reverse characteristics. Okay. Reverse characteristics. Before going to discuss reverse characteristics, we want to discuss some points. Under forward biasing, if the forward voltage less than the internal barrier potential difference, VO, this IF is zero. As I told you, unless you remove the potential barrier, you can't get current. Okay. So again, I am saying here, once you remove the barrier, this barrier, so barrier potential, here applied potential equal to barrier potential, then current will be zero. But as you increase the voltage beyond the potential barrier, then current increases sharply. And this has been written here. Now, Okay, so finally we want to discuss reverse characteristics. So reverse characteristics means, just you saw that we had connected the battery in forward biasing case. Here P type is connected with the negative terminal and N type is connected with the positive terminal. It means it is in reverse biasing mode. Again, this is ammeter, this is voltmeter, and purpose is same. We have to change the voltage accordingly, we will get current. Here you can see from the graph, this is voltage axis, this is current axis. So negative voltage applied, current is extremely small. Why? Whatever current is here, that is current is reverse biasing current, reverse current. So here current will be very, very, or you may say extremely small. Now if the voltage is increased further, at a certain voltage, suddenly we get large current. That is known as breakdown voltage. The voltage at which this is, we get large current. At a certain voltage, the covalent bonds near the junction break down and large number of electron hole pairs are liberated. The reverse current then increases abruptly to a relatively large value. The maximum voltage that a junction diode bear without breakdown is called Zener voltage or reverse breakdown voltage. Okay, so this was about forward forward characteristic and reverse characteristic. In the next video, we will discuss rectifier, PN junction diode as a rectifier. So before closing this video, again I am uploading pages one by one so that you can note it for your convenience. This is your first page. This is your second page. Okay. And this is your third page and the last page. Okay, thank you.